Welcome back, chaps. Well, we just picked that lock from Paul Springer, the quick set, T for two, it's called. So I still have a little bit of time. Let's try to get this asset. This is a Texas gem lock, I believe. It doesn't work. Okay, there's the Texas gem. There's the bitting on that key. Rustic looking key, proper Texas gem, hand file key, and it's a cool lock, very nice lock. That's a 600, I think is the model number there. Let's try not waste too much of your time and see if we can get this one picked and we'll have a look at what's inside. So I think I might be able to pick from the bottom of this one. Okay, so this one. You'd have to go clockwise to make that tension or work. Okay, let's see. Moving on one, click off two, off three. Four is a bit mushy or something. One, another click off two. Do the turn on the car. Think this is four. Five, slightly inside. Something dropped, I think. Okay, what's this? Three, two, one. Two, no more counter off two. Okay, nice spot set now. Counter off three. Four. So it's going deeper there, so I'm just hanging on a spool here, I think, somewhere. Okay, I think that was six. Let me see. Counter. Yes, six. Counter rotation off six. Okay, lost the fault set a bit. Let's tune again. I think I overset that guy. One, two, there we go. We got our full set back. Four. Five, nothing. Let's just start. Yes, okay, see that. Maybe one. It's good. Two. That's okay, maybe. Three wheels up. Okay, definitely counter rotation off pin four. See, five, solid, and then pin six wheels. Solid, that's weird, isn't it? It's like, touch pin one and fault set's gone a little deeper. Three, and then four, five. I think it's six again. Let's give six another try again. Six here. Get in behind them and get up on this ledge. So, definite counter rotation there. Definite. Okay, I'll click off there. So I can start at the front again. One, two, three, okay, yeah, here we go, four, five, six, oh, there we go, deep. One, two, three, yes, we got him, 4 minutes, 40 seconds, it's not so bad. Okay, let's get this fella gutted. I'm trying to waste too much of your guys' time. It's the part that slows me down. literally just finished picking Paul's lock. Nice job, Paul, on that lock. Good fun, by the way. And thanks again, mate, for all the foil and stuff. That was extremely generous. That was very nice of you indeed. So that's why that lock's still there. I'll put that back together in a moment. Let me see. Yeah, I have a key for this one there. Let's see if we can get away with this without locking it up, of course. Okay. I'll screw it over here. This might be overkill, though, a little for this. And it worked, it worked. I'm sure of a smaller one there somewhere, but yes, not too tight. Brilliant. Now, maybe I should put a smaller screwdriver up there. Alright, I have a smaller one there somewhere else. Don't go searching through to the box room. I'll turn this into a 20 minute video. Okay, let's just be careful, a little careful here. I was gonna say I might get away without a shim here, but why do that? If we can get a shim in, yes, yeah, let's use a shim. So if we can get the shim in, use it. And again, let's use a Foxy's follower. And where are the pins? There they are. Let's go. Now, yeah, awesome. Very cool lock. I think, where's the key gone? I think that's a Ruswin key. Looks like the RU45. It's a code on that one, so I'd imagine that's sort of this one. Very nice indeed. Okay, let's have a look at these babies. No, I think I can put them on this as well. One, two, three, four. Five and six. Very nice one. We have threading in. Yeah, threading in two, three, four. And six, two, three, four, and six. There's something in one there. There's like an undercut and one. The treading in two, treading in three. Mild treading in two and deep treading in three. Mild treading in four, and undercut in five, and mild treading there in six again. Very awesome. Very awesome indeed. Okay, we'll have a look at those pins in a moment. Sorry, it's gonna be a. Those really quickly. Very cool. Some very cool pins there. Right. Oh, into that gym. Okay, let's see what we have here. I can see this way. Oh. That's very nice. I guess right. T pin. Oh, but I'm messing with the springs in here. Don't take too much time. Nice spool. Oh, look at this guy. That's a T pin and a half as well. Sheesh. Another crazy serrated spool. Let's go, yeah. Get six and five from in here. Six, this is another spool, and five, is that a drunken spool? T-pin. Using that way, don't. I don't. There might be a wafer in there, but I don't want to go and dump all the springs. I don't think there's any work. No, it's all standard up in the car there. So I just put that there for 1 second and show you the pins on this one. Pin work here also. It's serrated, nice spool key pin, nice serrated spool, very nice. Oh, sorry, the Sorry guys, it's hard to get this to focus. There's a little look at the pins, just let me try something. There we go, that's a bit better. And as you see, a serrated spool, like a double spool, like a double spool serrated, and then in the top in one, is that a pin? No, I don't think so. Okay, so like a spool, serrated spool and a T-pin, very good. Like a standard spool almost, like a really sharp T-pin. Another double spill, a couple of serrations thrown in for good measure. Like an upside down T-pin, and then a spool there at the end. Very cool look. We can move that on now, send that into someone else. Listen, thanks a lot guys for sticking around, and like I said earlier, I hope everyone has a great day, and see you again on the next one. Cheers.